everyone, and today I'm going to be showing you how For I Loops work in Roblox Studio. Let's get into it. So you're going to want a script in subscript service. And what we're going to want to do is, if you know what a table is, skip to the timestamp on the screen, which I'll have like in the corner or something. If you don't know what a table is, I'm going to go over it now. So basically, a table is like, it's like a variable that holds multiple values. So say I made a table right now. So if I made local table equals, and then you have to put these brackets. Wait, let's just change that to, because that's really defined. Let's just do my table. So local my table, and then you could do like my table one. So that's gonna be like the first one of the table. Then we could do hi, and then my table two equals by. So we've got these, and then we do print my table one, then we print my table two. So basically, this should print in the output. This should print hi, bye. Okay, let's test it. So as you can see here, it says hi, bye. So now we've got tables out of the way, I'm just gonna use a like testing table. So let's just do local test table. Actually, I'll do test table one, because it's our first test table, because I'm gonna show you multiple examples of how you can use For I Loops. Just the simple ones. I'm not gonna be getting into the advanced stuff. It's just simple stuff. So we'll just create some stuff in this table, and I'll see you when I've created some stuff. Okay, so I've just put these in a table. So what we're gonna do is, well, for I, in the for I stands for index, and basically every time you run through the loop, it increases it by one. And what we're gonna wanna do is, so I is gonna start at one, so I equals one, then we do a comma, hashtag test table. So what this does is the index starts at one, and then for everything in this table, the test table will increase by one. And yeah, but for example, let's just do print I. So if I did print I, you may think, oh, it's just gonna say all the things, but no, it doesn't, because I is just how many times it loops through. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that's just, it counts how many are in the table. But what if we want it to count how many are in the table and also say what their name is? For I, V stands for value. Basically, it's what it is. So every time we run through the table, it has a value as well. So say the first one is the 2021 Koenigsegg Jesko Roche. It basically is the first one. So when the index is one, the value is 2021 Koenigsegg Jesko Roche. And then that's the script.parent, that's the children. And then we don't want the class name, we just want the name of it, because we want to know, like, what name of it, not what it is. Otherwise it'll just say model. Whatever. Yes, yeah, so we got the treehouse, Koenigsegg Jesko, noob model tree script. Yep, that is what we have in there. saying, guys, there are many situations this can be applied to, like data store, just getting values of things, finding how many things there are in something. I don't know. You get the idea. If you enjoyed, please leave a like and comment if I should do a tutorial on anything else. And subscribe if you like this kind of content, because I'll be doing more soon. And goodbye.